This is the fourth tutorial which we'll be using for our training purpose. Earlier, I used to jump on it and then put my experience and only do it in my regular way. But I thought Data Services has come up with this tutorial in a nice fashion so that we cover most of the functionalities that are provided by them. So that is the reason I wanted to still stick to whatever they have advised, and then at every point I will try to throw my own way of doing it. So what we'll be doing today, as I told you, I would try to answer your question which you had in mind yesterday: do we really require a template or not, and what are the guidelines for us to start working with. First, let us try to understand. Like yesterday, I showed you how I logged into Data Services repository. So as a developer, you will set up a local repository, or your administrator will give you access to the local repository. When you join a office, it will be fresh, brand new. You'll look only like this. It looks only like this. You have nothing more than what you see. You will not have any kind of projects or jobs or workflows, data flows, transforms, data stores. Nothing will be there. It's just an empty repository. And anytime you wanted to reformat the repository, that is also a possibility. You can back up your repository and then recreate it so that everything in your repository will be wiped out. That is one of the cleaning methods we just in case we have too much of garbage, how we do it, I will show you. But before we go there, as I was telling you, let us first start the show by understanding not the SAP architecture. SAP architecture, we already saw it. Somehow I clicked on the wrong PPT. The first thing we are going to see is the templating. First, give me an idea about whatever you might be thinking about the templates. The first question I have for you is, why do we require a template? Can't we perform, or can't we start working without a template? So let us just back up a little bit and then try to think in a regular fashion. So template, in general sense, is a place where for anyone, a developer or even if you look at it, your kitchen stadium is going to be templated, saying I have to have the stove at this height, and I will have all my spices on right hand side. I have four burners, which is one is small, one is big. I have something on my left hand side, the oil, everything. I have the chopping board. I have my sink nearby. So everything is arranged, right? In the same way, I see Sridevi has joined. Hi, Sridevi. Hello, do you hear me, Sridevi? Perfect. So we just kicked off the session. You haven't missed anything, so you're good. We are starting the session, and we are trying to understand, when you become a developer and get into a company, what do you do at first? So I'm trying to run the show by taking that as the first thing. Do we require a template? So there we are. So I was talking about a kitchen. So in a kitchen layout, even before you get into kitchen and then start working, there is a preset or predetermined arrangement. That is what is a template. So without having a predefined environment, your kitchen will be spoiled. Everyone who is going to come and cook some food in that kitchen is going to step over each other and mix everything and make it a mess. So we don't want that to happen. So we generally want it to be consistent across the organization when we start working. So there would be, at least now for our training purpose, we see there are five developers in the class. So all the five developers, you are going to all work in the same repository, which I'm going to provide in a couple of days, if you want a shared environment, so that you'll get used to it. Why I'm not asking just to work on your own desktops, installing it. You can always work when the system is too slow, but at least at some point of time, when you log on to my server and you everyone have to put some effort working on there, exchanging your job so that you get used to the real environment. That is where actually, because to be very honest, we are going to fake the resume a little bit. No one in the world wants a fresher because they are going to pay very high and no one wants to just keep a fresher in the project. So when you go there as an experienced person, you need to at least be careful that you should not step on each other's toe. Even in kitchen, you may be not making your recipe really well, but at least you should not cut your hand. You should not harm the co-chef or the cook over there. So that's where you'll have to actually get used to it. So you're going to be in a kitchen where there are five people cooking. Look at the food network, how they plan, how the layout will be, how each other will exchange the work. So it is the same thing we are going to do in our own development environment. So the first thing I would like to start is the same thing as I mentioned. Do we require a template? The question is how to start, where to start working, what to do, what not to do, what are the best practices suggested by data services. This is all we are going to focus on. So data services ETL job design. So I'm trying to give you a set of rules. Like when you try to do a behind the wheel exam in a DMV office, you better learn all the rules. Only then you are going to enjoy your driving, else you are going to scare everyone and you are also going to be in total loss. So that is the reason we wanted to go with a job template, and we would like to understand job framework, and we'd also see data services best practices. These are the three important things we need to work on before we hop and become a developer. It is the same as you're going to understand set of rules, that you'll have to stop at a red signal and give opportunity for other people to proceed, and then maintain the environment so that you'd avoid accidents. So that is the same purpose why we are using the template, why we are making this job framework and following the data services best practices. So the first thing is job template. For anyone, there will be a question, why do we require a job template? So a job in data services is not a reusable object, as it is at the top in the object hierarchy. So yesterday, if someone is asking me a definition of a job, this is the definition. It is an object, but it is not a reusable object. I mean, you can always drag any job into a different folder, that is possible, but we don't call it as reusable. In general, we feel the job is at the highest level of hierarchy, but you do have project folder at the highest level of hierarchy, which is just only a placeholder. It has no meaning in it. So if you put it into multiple projects or one project, there is no harm actually. But when you see at a job, it is actually makes sense. When you put when you break it into multiple jobs or you're running in a single job, it actually makes sense. We'll see when we start developing it. Go ahead. An object in data services is the definition wise every element that you are going to look at it from now is called as an object. Because yesterday, if you look at the screen, I was showing you an object library. So this is called as an object library. So whatever the function, whatever the job, whatever the workflow, whatever the data flow, anything you talk it in the form of an object. In data services, it is the integral part of the application. So whatever you develop, you have to call it as an object in generic sense. And then objects are two types, reusable, non-reusable. In that, a job falls under a non-reusable object in general. Whereas the workflows and data flows fell under a reusable object. A function is a reusable object. Okay. So definition wise, any member of data services is an object. Or if we go through the PDF, we may have a better definition of the object. But in the generic way, anything that is in data services is an object. Whatever you see in the designer, it is named as an object in generic sense. And what kinds of objects we have 6 to 7 types, and which are categorized into reusable and non-reusable. Okay. So in the template, are you fine with that answer so far? Yeah, we'd also get the definition closely when we look at the template over. It's not the template there. Okay, man. Thank you. So the purpose of template is to maintain a standard job format across the organization. So there are 5 to 6 developers in an organization. If everyone try to put their own style, it is not an individual running race. It is kind of a team effort that you are going to play cricket or football. It is not an independent tennis court where you are going to beat your enemy or beat the other participant. So it is an team effort. You'll have to coordinate properly. Only then you can taste the win. So it is a plug and play object that can be renamed or replicated. So when you design a template, you can always rename it and then make use of it. Or the best way is you replicate it and then make use of it. When I say renaming, I will let you know what are all the instructions you'll have to follow when you rename a template and make use it for your own self. I see Syed arrived. Hi, Syed. Syed, let me know when you hear me. Syed, do you hear me? Okay. So we already kicked off the class because it is half an hour. We waited for 15-20 minutes, but I couldn't see you. So you haven't missed anything major. We are talking about job template, which we actually started yesterday discussing about why we require a template. So I'm trying to give a proper reason why we require a template to start working with. So you are on the right time in the class. So hold on 1 second. I'm actually getting call from my home, which could be Krishna should be calling me. So give me 1 second. If he's having some trouble logging in, I'll have to send him the login details. No problem. Sorry to call you guys. Because he told me that he's joined. Yeah. నేను కనెక్ట్ అయ్యాను బాలు బహుశా ఐ మీన్ తన దగ్గర ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ రాలేదేమో తనకి యాక్చువల్లీ మెయిల్ బౌన్స్ అయింది పోయినసారి పంపించినప్పుడు సో ఐఎమ్ సెండింగ్ హిమ్ ఓకే కనెక్ట్ అవ్వలేదు బాలు ఇంకా యా పంపించాను ఇప్పుడే అండ్ తను అక్క సెల్ నుంచి కాల్ చేస్తా ఉన్నట్టున్నాడు చెప్పు నేను సెషన్ లో ఉన్నాను ఓకే యా ఆల్రెడీ పంపించాను గైస్ ఐఎమ్ బ్యాక్ యా